Tall, waving cornfields that line Midwestern roads may one day be replaced by dwarfed versions of the plants that require less water and fertilizer, thanks to Purdue researcher Burkhard Schulz.
A small plant, and specifically if you think about crops and cereal crops, is very beneficial. Short plants are much sturdier against wind and rain and weather, and short plants certainly also need much less water and nutrients to produce the same amount of seeds.
By knocking out steroids in corn, Schulz found the plants became smaller and feminized. Those feminized plants develop more kernels where pollen would normally grow.
We study the basic biology of steroids and the role that steroids play in plants. Steroids are known as hormones in animals and human systems, but plants also have steroids and they need them for elongation of cells, to simply to grow. And you see a plant that has no steroids and a plant that is making steroids, you see the differences in size right away. So we work with different species of plants. What you see here in front of me looks like corn, but it is not corn. It is sorghum, which is a very important food plant in Africa and Asian countries mostly. We use it here for bird feed, more or less. But what you see behind me is Indiana's state flower, so to speak. It is corn. And for corn, we found that if you take away the steroids from a corn plant, you make a corn plant that has a male and a female flower totally female. So you feminize the entire plant. We can use chemicals to chemically inhibit the production of steroids.
But the chemical used to do this was prohibitively expensive, so Schulz looked for a more affordable option.
So what we found was fungicides that are actually very cheap and can be used to induce exactly the same phenotype, which means the inhibition of steroids in a plant and the dwarfing of a plant as a result of that.
The ability to produce dwarf plants has many benefits, with no loss of yield.
Think about hailstorms and wind and rain that comes in the summertime sometimes at the wrong time, actually, and simply destroys big parts of the field. These plants would be much, much more resistant to that and would still stand after they were rained with a very hard rain in the summertime. The yield in this plant is more or less the same than the non-treated sorghum plant. So the amount of yield that we get, the amount of kernels that we get from each plant, is very similar of a treated and a non-treated plant.
Schulz plans to test other grain crops to see if these discoveries can be used to manipulate the height of other plants.
We know now exactly which genetic information is responsible for the steroid production. So we will go out and try to clone more genes from sorghum in this case, to study them and to be able to manipulate the height of the plant just by the production level of the steroids in these plants.